I never forget when I first found out about my breast cancer. Several would say, cancer has been a blessing. And I've heard that over the years. I thought, what do you mean it's a blessing? How can chemo and surgery and feeling bad and no energy, how can that be a blessing?
When I first came to this school, she was already here, and she immediately wanted to know how she could help me, what she could do.
Kay has a tremendously large heart, and I know that sometimes we use this symbol to show how much we love someone and show heart. I couldn't make a symbol big enough to show the size of Kay's heart that she has for these children in this school.
My favorite probably is working in the cafeteria in the morning, because I can see the kids, talk with them, try to get them off on a good day. It's just one of my happy places.
She was diagnosed with breast cancer last November, and when she told me, she was positive. And she has stayed positive through this entire experience, and she has missed very little school, even though she has had to go through chemotherapy, she's had doctor's appointments, she's had surgery. When she did come back, she started working half days after her surgery and she couldn't handle it. So she came back full days before the doctor allowed her to. But she just wanted to be in this building and she wanted to be around the kids and she missed them so much.
She helps us support. She's very funny. She'll
like
all the time, she'll come in
our
room and she always make cookies for us.
She's really strong because she had cancer, but she still comes to work every day to take care of everybody.
She comes in my room every day and she is there and she helps other kids.
She is definitely loving to everyone in this building, our staff and students. Her kindness and how she interacts with everyone is noticeable.
My mom is the person that I called when we got a foster placement in January, and she's the reason the little girl had clothes for the next day, because she sees the importance of making the difference of a moment.
This world is hard enough. And that's why I love elementary school, because you can start out and teach them that things can be positive. Yeah, the world is hard, but you can find something positive about it and something to be thankful for.
We are, you know, a pretty high free and reduced lunch school. Feeding our kids was important to us. And so we, our counselor worked really hard to put together, you know, like feeding schedules, and the district did have buses, but not all of our families had cars to get to those feeding sites. So Ms. B was one of the first ones that said, how can I help? You know, and this was when we were, you know, pretty securely on lockdown and, you know, we needed to take precautions, but, you know, without any thought about her own safety, it was, these kids need us and we're gonna make it happen.
Kids that come to school with their shoes on the wrong feet, or, you know, they have their shirt on backwards. She sees it, she pulls them to the side, she helps them, like, she doesn't need to be asked.
How can chemo and surgery and feeling bad and no energy, how can that be a blessing? It opened up what I saw in people. My husband, my girls, my grandchildren, and this staff has been absolutely incredible. I came back to work as soon as I could because I wanted to be here. That's why I'm always hurrying. I want to get to the next child, to the next teacher. I don't want to waste time. It has been a blessing because it's opened up things that I didn't see before.